This is InfoLife TV headline news, November 29th. I'm Margot Dutkevich. U.S. President George Bush said Wednesday the agreement by Israel and Palestinian leaders to resume long-stalled peace talks was a hopeful beginning. One thing I've assured both gentlemen is that the United States will be actively engaged in the process, Bush said. We will use our powers to help to lay out a Palestinian state that will live side by side in peace with Israel. Israel's sovereignty over the Temple Mount is not up for discussion, Prime Minister Olmert said Wednesday, a day after Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas said a Palestinian capital in East Jerusalem was key to an agreement with Israel. Talks will be tough, Olmert said. If the day comes when the two-state solution collapses and we face a South African-style struggle for equal voting rights, the state of Israel is finished. U.S. Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice named retired Marine General James Jones as special envoy for Middle East security, focusing on Palestinian and Israeli security issues. Rice said the former NATO commander was the person needed to take up the vital mission. For the first time in the history of Israel Air Force, a woman has been appointed as deputy squadron commander. Captain Yifat will be appointed second deputy commander of the freight transport squadron. She began her career in the Air Force as an assistant controller in the Forces Control Unit. In light of the month-and-a-half-long teacher strike and the ongoing lecturer strike at the universities and the severe harm caused to the education system, 39 Knesset members signed a petition calling on Prime Minister Olmert to dismiss Education Minister Yuli Tamir due to her handling of the educational crisis. According to reports, the petition was initiated by Transport Minister Shaul Mofaz. 60 years ago, on November 29, 1947, the State of Israel was born. The vote of the United Nations resolution recommended the end of the British Mandate of Palestine and partition of the land into two independent states, one Arab and one Jewish. Elsewhere on InfoLive TV, Annapolis generates mixed reactions. And that's all from InfoLive TV, wishing you all the best from Jerusalem.
InfoLife.tv, live on your mobile phone. Do you want to keep ahead of the news and receive updates on what is happening in Israel? InfoLife.tv offers you a unique service, regular video news updates, free of charge, on your cell phone. To sign up, enter our website at www.infolive.tv and click on the mobile services banner. Today, the whole world talks about Israel. But who broadcasts from Israel to the world in four languages, live from Jerusalem? InfoLive TV, the first international Israeli television channel that operates 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Follow current events in Israel and the Middle East. Video features, interviews, news programs, and news briefs live as history unfolds. If you want a direct link to Israel, access InfoLive.tv.